Merry Christmas, and now it's time for the round table. We have extended our show for 30 to 45 minutes today, because today is our final program. On today's broadcast, David Washington and gang are still talking about Rocky 3, 4, 5, and the final movie, Rocky Balboa. And now, your host, the founder of DJ Wash 5, David Washington. Good morning, everybody. Merry, merry Christmas. Welcome to the round table. I'm David Washington.
I'm Tom Barracraft.
Wrong, you're Chuck Strongbax.
Right, I'm Tom Barracraft.
I'm Chuck Strongbax.
I'm David Roxborough.
Good morning, I'm Richard Stark.
And I'm Chuck Davidson. How you doing?
Well, I'm not doing good today.
Why not, Dave?
Because today is my final show.
Oh, no!
Yes, I know. But we'll forge ahead with our weather update with Richard Stark, followed by our Philadelphia food fact, and right on to the show. First, our weather update with Richard Stark, our meteorologist.
On Monday night, Christmas Eve night, rain likely, mainly before midnight. Cloudy, with a low of 35. Northwest wind about 6 miles per hour, becoming light and variable. Chance of precipitation is 40%. On Christmas Day, partly sunny. I'm sorry, kids, no snow today.
Oh, no!
You know, I really like those talent criers. They're funny.
I know.
Partly sunny with a high of 44 degrees. On Wednesday, after Christmas, Boxing Day, or Kwanzaa, whatever the heck that is, rain and snow, high of 45 degrees. Chance of precipitation is 100%. Thursday, a chance of rain, mostly cloudy, with a high of 40 degrees. Chance of precipitation is 30%. We're heading back to the sunny side, but cool and cold on Friday. Mostly sunny with a high of 38 degrees. On Saturday, a mix of rain or snow. Rain and snow. I should say snow because snow is really good. Rain and snow, partly sunny with a high of 38 degrees. Chance of precipitation is 30%. For KDJW Weather, I'm Richard Stark.
Thank you very much. And now it's time for the Philadelphia Food Fact.
And now it's time for the Philadelphia Food Fact with Tom Barracraft. Good morning, everybody. I'm very sorry. This is our final show for this Christmas rush. But we've extended it just for you, so we hope you enjoy your morning coffee or your bacon, scrapple, and eggs. And speaking of scrapple, our Philadelphia Food Fact is about scrapple, so let's get down to it. Scrapple is typically made of hog offal, such as the head, heart, liver, and other trimmings, which are boiled with any bones attached, quote, often the entire head, close quotes, to make a broth. Once cooked, bones and fat are discarded, the meat is reserved, and dry cornmeal is boiled to the broth to make a mush. The meat is finely minced, is returned to the pot, and seasonings, typically sage, thyme, savory, black pepper, I'm sorry, I'm getting right into my silly cowpoke thing, and others are added. The mush is formed into loaves and allowed to cool thoroughly until set. The preparations and seasonings are very much a matter of the region and the cook's taste. A few manufacturers have introduced beef and turkey varieties and colored the loaf to retain the traditional coloration derived from the original pork liver base. Home recipes for chicken and turkey scrapple are also available. Scrapple is best known as a rural American food of the Mid-Atlantic states, Delaware, Pennsylvania, New Jersey, Maryland, and Virginia. For the Philadelphia Food Facts, I'm Tom Barracraft.
We hope you enjoy our program. Coming up next is Action News, followed by ABC World News Tonight with Peter Jennings. I'm Jeff Kay.
Sort of slide in a little Jeff Kay for you in memory of the incredible voice actor and voice announcer, voiceover announcer for WPVI Action News. We shall miss him. Well, we're just getting started on the roundtable, so stay tuned. We'll be right back and have a cup of eggnog and a good cheer, okay? We'll be right back with our final episode of the roundtable right after this. Merry Christmas, folks! Join us on the Facebook community at Channel 5 Philadelphia KDJW-TV, on Twitter at DJWatch5Philly, and check out our email address simply down on the bottom of our screen. The roundtable will continue right after this. Hi, folks. I'm David Washington. You know, people smoke a lot, and it's time for you to stop. Smoking increases lung cancer, and I want you to know smoking is a terrible thing to do, and it's a deadly thing to do. Call 1-800-QUIT now, or visit smokefreephilly.org today. Remember, Philadelphia, your life depends on it. Your founder and president, David Washington of DJ Wash 5 and DWDP Productions, and I approve this message.
And now, back to more Roundtable with Tom Barracroft, Chuck Strongbacks, David Roxborough, Richard Stark, Chuck Davidson, and founder and president, David Washington. Ho, ho, ho! Merry Christmas, everybody! Let's get back to more Rocky Balboa. Now, we're just about to set things to a good low here. Okay, now, Rocky 3. Apollo Creed helped out Rocky, and After their talk, they moved to Los Angeles, California, miles away from Philadelphia, PA, and they were starting to train in the California coast for the comeback of Rocky's retainment of the World Heavyweight Championship medal and stuff.
It was a hard fight since Mickey died.
It sure is. Things are flashing around through Rocky, you know, like saying, "You can't win, Rock! You can't win!" I'm just so sad about it right now. It took a lot of time to train for Rocky, since he's going through the death of his dear friend and manager, Mickey Goldberg. It's Mickey, you know, he's a great guy. And Jewish and Italian, you know. Well, anyway, Apollo has tried so many things to help appease the mourning going away. So he says, "What's the matter with you? Let's do it tomorrow." "There is no tomorrow! There is no tomorrow!" So, you know, he tried so hard to train, but he was slipping away after he hears all the things in his mind.
Yeah, it's terrible.
But one thing that got him up with his wife, he just blatantly said to his wife, "I'm afraid!" Yeah. So anyway, so that's when the training begins. For real! And also, of course, Rocky did win back his championship. Taking left and right combinations and all this stuff. It's like, "You ain't so bad! You ain't so bad! You ain't so bad!" You know what I mean, right?
Yeah, that's really cool.
You can say that again.
Off question, David.
What?
How come almost all the Rocky films are in Philadelphia, they moved to Los Angeles, California?
You know, Richard, that's a good question. I don't know the answer, but I'll tell you when we're off the air.
Right, and since it's your last day here on KDJW, I think it is my last day as well.
Oh, no!
I know. We're going to miss you, Richard.
Yes, we're going to miss you, Richard.
You've been a great guy, man.
We hope we are friends again. Don't worry, friend. I'm always your friend.
Touching. Really touching. Well, anyway, now off to Rocky IV about the about this hard iron dude name of Ivan Drago. Now, this is the part where he won the championship, and oh, yeah, I forgot the final part, which is about to becoming the beginning of Rocky IV. He says he was talking about how they do their first fight. So he wants to prove for himself that it's not really to be. So they took off all their clothes. They put on their boxing shorts, boxing shoes, and boxing gloves. And they come out at each other.
Yeah. How the heck do they do that, man? We're all, they're friends, no?
Then, here's one funny thing. One funny thing here. The time that Rocky came back, it was Paulie's birthday. And Paulie was a little angry that Rocky is getting late. Rocky is coming home late, you know what I mean.
Yeah, I believe he does.
Well, anyway, luckily he came, and he got his birthday present.
Is it a car?
Nope.
Is it a case of beer?
Nope.
Is it a, hot sports model?
Hot sports... Richard! I can't believe you said that in front of millions of kids for crying out loud.
Sorry. Oh, no, I'm not sorry. He's sorry.
That's right, I'm very sorry.
It's quite all right, Richard. Just don't do it again. Oh, good grief. I can't believe he said that. Now, here's another part. It's a robot.
A robot? Say, happy birthday, Polly. Don't worry, I'll clean it up for you.
So anyway, after that, it was like almost like years since Rocky was married to Adrian, and it was nice. He gave her a little present, like a little watch that wraps around with a little gold, you know. That's really, really great. And they kissed. It was a very nice couple. A match made in heaven, the couple. Yes.
It sure is, David.
Well, on to the rest of Rocky IV. Before we get started, I have a little announcement to make. I am going to somewhere else, so there won't be any internet, so I won't be able to do any more roundtable or quizmaster stuff. So I don't know when I'll peep in on the internet to give you a shout out or whatnot, but I'll shout one to you anyway. This show is for Patty in South Philadelphia. How you doing, Patty?
Hello, Patty.
Hello, Patty. Richard Stark here.
Hello, Patty.
Yeah.
Hey, Patty, how you doing, friend?
I'll be praying for you. That's sweet. Well, anyway, we'll be back with more of the roundtable when we come back, so don't go away, okay? The gentle breeze of the Philadelphia morning, and Rocky climbing up his first steps of the art museum. Beautiful, isn't it? The roundtable will continue right after this on KDJW Radio.
Hello, this is Tom Bettycroft. Are you tired of paying retail markup? Well, go to Society Hill Loan at South Street and 7th. Don't be late. Go right away.
Welcome back to the roundtable, folks. I'm David Washington. We're getting on to Rocky IV right now. Apollo was the first one to see the Russian man, Ivan Drago. And he's saying that he has some freakish sort of strength. And the wife says, it's like your spinach, like your Popeye. You know, he has spinach every day. Well, anyway, I'll probably tell you what he had a little later. But in the meantime, Apollo was talking to Rocky, talking to Adrian, and talking to Polly about fighting that big dude. He's been long retired, man. Long retired.
Yeah, he is retired, man.
Yeah, he gotta rest, you know, take care of the doggies like he did in the pool.
Yeah, like he's throwing tennis balls at them, you know, playing around.
Yeah, that would have been a great life for Apollo. So, no, he decided not to listen to them, so he went on his own. And during that time at the exhibition fight, when everybody showed how how Ivan Drago punches is like 1,850 pounds per square inch of the force of how he boxed like that. He will mentalize that guy. Goodness knows, you know?
Yeah, David, it's terrible. I say it's terrible. It is no fair that one person should have a bigger guy like a Goliath, you know, with a freakish sort of strength like steroids or something. Haha, that's it! Steroids! That's what got him stronger.
Ooh, that's terrible.
It sure is. But Rocky will have to come toe-to-toe to him a little later on. Well, we're over the 50-minute delay. We're still going on strong, aren't we?
Darn right. You can say that again. Darn right.
Richard, welcome to America.
Ah, thank you, David. God bless you, and God bless us, everyone.
You've been watching too many of the Christmas Carol?
I like Alistair Sim. He's really funny.
Me too. How'd you know? How'd you know the way I watch? Oh, sorry. Back to the round table.
Yes, it's a complicated thing, folks. You wouldn't understand.
They would understand. They're all my fans. God bless them. God bless you all. Let's get back to the round table. Now, on to the exhibition fight after Rocky and Apollo were talking, you know. So, anyway, the bell rings. That's my Liberty Bell right here.
That's Freedom Ring, baby.
Yeah. Anyway, he was like going after toe-to-toe after that flamboyous introduction from the late Godfather of Soul, James Brown.
Wow, I feel good.
So, you know, after the bell rings, Apollo and Ivan Drago are going along. He punched Apollo so much he fell down. And he's saying, I'm going to stop the fight. Apollo's like, you ain't stopping nothing. You ain't stopping nothing. Don't throw me no towel. I'll be right back. Apollo is stubborn. He don't even listen to his best friend. His best friend who, you know, is terrible. So he went down with one punch. They didn't throw the towel. And, oh, goodness, Apollo died. It is a sad, sad day. It's a sad day for his wife, his children, his best friend Rocky, and everybody.
It is so sad.
Well, oh yeah, this show goes out to is a memory for all the kids out there who were shot at the Newtown shootings in the elementary school. And I'm sorry we didn't get that part in. So I wish you the best, families of the children, and one day God will richly bless you, and hopefully, I mean, don't get sad now, because we're still remembering all the children out there. So Apollo died, and Rocky goes, you're always a true champion, Apollo. So he laid the heavyweight medal, or the belt, right on his grave, and they all walked off. It's so, so sad. Yeah.
Oh, gosh. It is a tough blow, David.
I know.
I'm sorry.
Richard, are you crying?
I'm sorry. This stuff happened, you know, is really sad for me.
I know what you mean.
Well, anyway, amidst of the sad news, Rocky, Paulie, and everybody else had a little conference with Ivan Drago about having the fight. A non-sanctioned fight. It's not for the title. It is not for the money, not for anything. Just a little bout between Rocky Balboa and Ivan Drago in Russia. And Mrs. Balboa was peppered with questions with all the press. Channel 10 wasn't there yet. I'll let you know when on the next Rocky. And she says, I don't know what you're talking about. So Rocky came back and they
that night, and, you know, she said, "You can't win." So the call comes out that his wife, Adrian, doesn't believe that he's going to win over that big hulking He-Man named of Ivan Drago.
I mean, gosh, look at his strength, man. He can chop you down in size.
Hey, now wait a minute!
Sorry, David.
I want you to know Ivan Drago is a fictitious character, and there's no way in the North Pole that he's going to come down and beat me when I'm on the radio on KDJW. For now, until we sign off.
Yeah.
There's always an old chuckle over there. You can chuckle if you like to. It's some funny stuff here. Now, they went on a plane from the outskirts of Philadelphia all the way to Russia, Ivan Drago's home country.
David, I have an inside note.
An inside note? Uh-oh. You better get on the, we better have some theme music.
I want you to know, folks, Rocky Balboa, Rocky IV is made not only in Philadelphia, in the Delaware Valley, is also made in, not in Russia either.
Well, where the heck is it made?
In crispy, cold Canada.
Oh, Canada, I see.
Yeah.
So there you have it, folks, that's newscast. Rocky went to Canada, but actually it is fictitiously known as Russia, so you know. So the whole thing is made in Canada.
Darn it.
I thought it was in Russia, for crying out loud. I seen all the Russian flags, but it's Canada? I don't believe this.
I don't believe it either. We gotta call a halt.
Tell you what, we gotta call for a commercial break. The Roundtable will be right back with more of Rocky IV, V, and the last movie, Rocky Balboa. Merry Christmas, everybody. Hi, folks. I'm David Washington. For all the people who are in the holiday rush, this is the last day for Christmas shopping. Please, be careful, be alert, and please, for goodness sakes, don't get hurt. I'm David Washington, and I approve this message. Hi, everybody. Welcome back to the Roundtable. I'm David Washington with all my crew, and Charlie Martin doing a darn good job. Thank you very much, David. I really appreciate that. Now, on to the fight. But first, have some serious training going on. Some training for Apollo Creed. I'm sorry, Apollo Creed, he passed away. So anyway, Rocky, Duke, and Polly went into a house that doesn't have no TV, no comics, not even a cup of coffee. So, all the mechanical things he likes, like barbells or jump rope, so he can jump rope around, is all in the barn. He was training so hard to do it alone, and Tony always been faithful to him, like his predecessor champ Apollo Creed. Yeah. So anyway, Adrian came over to say, "I'm behind you 100%. So now he goes into training. Hearts on fire. Well, you know, like that. I don't know the words, but you know what I mean. That's from Survivor.
Yeah, it's great, man.
Thank you. Well, anyway, I'm not much of a singer, you know.
You'll be able to sing on the last part of the show.
Oh, yeah. Chestnuts roasting. I gotcha. Well, anyway. then on to the big fight. Rocky wore Apollo's colors, let him know they're from the United States of America. And he's saying, Rocky's brother-in-law, Apollo, goes like, "I know I'm sound a little stupid, but if I want to be someone, I'll unzip myself and become you. Now I'll ice this guy, like that, blast his teeth in, like that." So anyway, after the big fight, it was like a humongous fight. He cut him so hard, Rocky cut that guy. Ivan Drago so hard, there's blood coming out. He's saying, he's no machine, he's a man! Now go after him! All your strength, all your love! No pain, no pain, no pain, no pain! So anyway, they went toe-to-toe for the final time. Ivan Drago went down like a bad habit, and Rocky won for his friend. He made a motivating speech. If I can change, you can change, everybody can change. And there's one thing to my son, who should be sleeping. Merry Christmas, kid! I love you, Dad. It was touching. So after that, transitioning to Rocky V, probably the final one in the 1990s, so it won't be anymore. So anyway, they went back to Philadelphia after all that, saying, I want to go home, Mick. I want to go home. As he said to his wife. So anyway, they went back, and out of the blue, they had a little press conference. How was your trip in Canada? I'm sorry, Russia. Do you speak any Russian, Mrs. Balboa? She speaks little vodka, you know what I mean? I don't drink vodka, you know. Oh, yes, he drinks vodka. I saw him last night at a party. Hey! That's not fair. I don't drink. I am 100% sober. Don't forget that. Sorry. It's okay, Richard. You've been drinking vodka. What? Just kidding. Just trying to get you back. Do-do-do-do. Take you back. So after the talk and the big guy, George Washington Duke. George Washington Duke here challenging Rocky Balboa. Like that. So anyway, Union Kane for the heavyweight champion. I'll take what you got. Like that. So anyway, after all that talk, saying, I'm going to go home now. I'm going to be retiring. So anyway, after all that, they went home. And he was talking to his son, Sage Stallone. Sage. Oh. Sage Moonblood Stallone. A great kid. God bless him. I wish he was here right now. Well, anyway, after that drawing he did about his French teacher, Madame DuPont.
Ooh, bad boy. Even at, what, 12, 13 years old?
Puberty is at an all-time high, you know.
Yeah, it is really high.
Well, anyway, after the talk, goodnight, kid, we'll play tomorrow. Rocky's wife and Rocky's brother-in-law, Paulie and Adrian, they're fighting because Paulie gave power of attorney to the guy, and the money is all gone. Darn that, Paulie. He should be horsewhipped.
Yes, he should be horsewhipped.
Darn right. I'll get a whip, and I'll horse him. I mean, I'll get a whip, and I'll horsewhip him. How about that? Easy. This is work. This is Christmas time, man. And have a little jolly, for goodness sake.
Right. I'm sorry. Fictitious character, I know. My apologies, everybody. And Father Christmas, do send a little gift down for me. And not a piece of coal.
Touching. Very touching. Well, we're just getting started on the roundtable, Rocky V, and here's more to come. Right now. So anyway, they went over to the doctor and saying that, he suffered trauma around his brain area, so he can't fight anymore. He cannot be titled or whatnot. Not even a manager. Nothing. Not even, what's that again? I forgot the word, but anyway, he cannot be signed in for fights anymore. So he retired, and all the papers were talking about it, including Action News. No, I'm sorry. Action is not included. I'm sorry, folks. So anyway, after that, he went on to his old clothes and he went over to Andy's. After Andy's, he went back home to Kensington, Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. And then, here's the big part. After that, he went over back to his hometown. Mr. Duke called the Balboa phone number. Mrs. Balboa, George Washington Duke.
Do you hear it? I don't know if you can hear it. Can you hear it?
Hear what?
The sound of parade of opportunity knocking. Let me have your husband's career and you'll be swimming with money. You know, saying, "Don't bother my husband," she said. And that's it. He said, "Women." So anyway, he never gives up easily. So he went. So after Pauly, Rocky walked his son Robert home, they went over to their old fighting gym. And then they saw a young kid named Tommy Morrison, also known as Tommy Gunn. Tommy Morrison is a Christian now. He was on the Trinity Broadcast Network's Praise the Lord a long time ago.
Amen.
Yeah, amen. Well, anyway, moving on aside, Rocky has an unexpected visit from Merlin and George Washington Duke. Terrible. Always saying, "I want you to fight again. You're the true product to the people, you know." And Mrs. Balboa came out of the pet shop. She called Gloria again for some part-time work. She was there to be close to him. So anyway, after all that, Rocky's kid got into a fight, took his coat. Terrible. Anyway, a girl walked him home after the little debacle of the guy versus Tommy Gunn. Tommy Gunn was fighting so hard, saying, "What are you doing, man? This is sparring, not street fighting." He wants to have a manager, so you know. So anyway, I wish I can do some more. We're in 30 minutes of a program. I love this stuff.
If you love it too, send us an email or simply drop in our comments down below the screen.
Yeah, good idea. So anyway, after all that, Tommy came to see Rocky again. He says, I don't have any family, you know. So Rocky took him in. Bad mistake. So anyway, he moved into the little kid's room, which is the basement. I like to live down in the basement one day. Have my own little pad, little television set, you know, and Coca-Cola, you know. But not the one that doesn't have the phosphorus. It's yucky. Well, anyway, after they moved in, Rocky is neglecting his son. All the times he was going over to school, he's been beaten up, taking his money. It's not fair. It is not fair. But he met a girl named Jewel. She's a cool kid.
Yeah, sure is.
Well, anyway, slowly and comingly, when he was becoming a great fighter, George Washington Duke has an idea to get Rocky back fighting again. After all the time of the short club fights, you know, newspapers saying Rocky's bomber up at top, he's traveling everywhere in the Delaware Valley fighting and fighting and fighting, 22-0 he is, doesn't have any money yet, just a little handshake. So anyway, slowly, Mr. George Washington Duke was seeping in to handle him, you know. So a little later on, after Robert beats the heck out of that kid and took his coat back, he went over to see his dad, but dad says, "That's great, I'll talk to you later." He's sweating up here. Tell your mom, she likes to hear good things about that, good things. Still neglecting his kid, for goodness sake. Will this ever end?
It's terrible, man. Fathers, you should never, I repeat, never take time for everybody except your children. So for goodness sakes, man, don't be that way. Thank you.
I want you to know that's the best answer that's the best comment in the entire world.
Thank you, David. I really appreciate that.
You're welcome, Chuck. Hey, David! Yeah? It's time for a commercial break? Nope, we're still going on. Okay, I'll be sipping my eggnog. Okay, do that. Hey, wait a minute! Come here. Yes, David? Doesn't have any alcohol, is it? Doesn't have any alcohol, right? No, it's unalcoholic eggnog made with pure milk, some cinnamon, cloves, and tasty. Okay, go right ahead. And vanilla extract? Yeah, the one without any alcohol.
Perfect.
Go right ahead and drink your eggnog. Hope you're drinking your eggnog, folks. The roundtable show going on strong with Rockies 5 and 6. I'll probably do like a little snippet of Rocky Snick, Rocky Balboa. Sorry about the little the little mistakes there. Well, anyway, it was going on Christmas Day, and Sooner as the father is moving away, you know, he went over. George Washington Duke came over to see Rocky and family, saying, "Merry Christmas, my lord! Greetings! Merry Christmas, my lord!" Oh, brother. Lord have mercy. Well, anyway, he dropped off to get some presents, and Tommy was arguing with Rocky, saying, "It's my way or the highway." Drove off with a brand new car, Cadillac, 1990s Cadillac. I don't know what kind of Cadillac it is. Fill on to me. What kind of Cadillac was on Rocky V? I want to know. It's a great Cadillac. It's like a top like a Cadillac convertible. It's in the 1990s, early 90s, like a new 91 or 1989 Cadillac. Let me know, okay? And I'll answer your comment back. So anyway, had a bit of a headache, and then Adrian goes like, "You're losing us! Rocky, you're losing your family! Like that. So anyway, after that, he made amends with his son. His real son, you know. Home team. So after that, Rocky's not the manager anymore of Tommy Gunn, you know. And I want you to know, it's really terrible. Everybody was booing for that guy, Tommy Gunn. So anyway, he fought the champion, and Rocky is with him, you know, not with him, like he was like, you know, bombing away. So after he won the championship, he dissed his manager, Rocky Balboa, saying, "There's only one person I'd like to thank who's the angel in my corner, Mr. George Washington Duke," and everybody was booing like mad. I want you to know, Michael Buffer, the guy who says, "Let's get ready to rumble," was somewhere in that film, including in the next one, Rocky VI. Rocky Balboa, that is. And I want you to know, Michael Buffer was also born and raised in the fighting city of Philadelphia, going, "Let's get ready to rumble." And Charlie O'Donnell, he was a good announcer, too. He was born and raised in Philadelphia. WIBG Radio was like before you know about him when he moved to Hollywood. We're not talking about him right now, so I want to put a little bit of snippet of history of Michael Buffer and Charlie O'Donnell, both announcers living in Philadelphia, born and raised. Now, he went over to Andy's Lucky Seven Tavern. You know that place, folks. You know that place. Somewhere in northeast Philadelphia where Rocky likes to make merry with his friends. That's great. Anyway, after the argument of George Washington Duke saying, "You gotta fight that man, Rocky Balboa, man to man, you're a darn fool." Like that. So anyway, after that, he went over. The girl was there with the long red hair. Pretty. Merlin was there. Duke was there, including Tommy Gunn and the cameraman from WCAU-TV.
WCAU? What happened to WPVI? I thought Channel 6 was the Delaware Valley's leading news program. Channel 10, what's going on, man?
Oh, yeah. What's going on? We saw WCAU-TV of the in Rocky 2, and we're seeing it again in Rocky 5. Wow, what a historic concept with the old 10 logo with a microphone flag and a cameraman. I don't know who the reporter is, but I think it's famous.
Yeah.
Broadcast Pioneers of Philadelphia, shouting out to you, Art Wilson, and Jackie Strauss. Hey, Jackie, how you doing? All the broadcasting folks out there who's watching the program, The Roundtable, hello, Broadcast Pioneers and Mark Howard. I met him during my visit to KYW 1060 Studios. It was incredible. I like it.
Yeah, Mark Howard was the guy.
Yeah, now back to The Roundtable. Big street fighter was. He was, Rocky and Tommy are going gun to gun, saying, "My ring's outside. You knocked him down. Why don't you try to knock me down now?" Like that. So anyway, after he went down, he saw a vision of Mickey saying, "He's no machine! Get up, you stinking bum! 'Cause Mickey loves you." Then he rises up and beats the heck out of Tommy Gunn. And after that, "Touch me and I'll sue. Come on, Buck. Touch me and I'll sue." Then blam! He punched him in his stomach, went up in the car, blam, right down to his limousine. "Sue me for what?" he's a darn fool. Doesn't have the cojones in the family. "Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to say that." Well, anyway, we're going to do a last snippet of Rocky Balboa. "It ain't hard. It ain't how hard you hit is about you get hit and you keep moving forward. That's how winning is done." Anyway, I'll probably have a few comments about Rocky Balboa, the movie, down on this, on the comments list, like how you can have Rocky Balboa into your home so you can have your own little round table talking about it. Anyway, if you have a YouTube channel, get your webcam or whatever and get on your computer and talk about Rocky Balboa. That'll be your round table. So do that, folks, okay? And I have to say, I have to quit when I'm behind.
Oh no!
And the sad conclusion is, this is our final roundtable show. I'm very sorry we have to end this way. We have more stuff to do, more Philadelphia food facts, but now it is your turn. I'm passing the mantle to anybody on this YouTube channel, or anybody who has their own YouTube channels, to whip up your own roundtable, whip up your own comments, whip up everything you need, like a memorial for me. Which I'm not will be on the air anymore. I'll probably be on the air in 5 years, you know. But well, anyway, thank you for watching the roundtable with us, and thank you very much for being here. Thank you very much for being my peeps. You know what I mean? Yeah, Dave, you speaking my language, kid. Yeah. Well, anyway, Tom Barrowcroft, thank you very much for being here.
Anytime, David. It is always nice to do the Philadelphia Food Facts and the Friday Night News.
Yeah. Chuck Strongbex, you take it easy, okay?
You bet, David. I'll always be with you.
Chuck Davidson?
David, I know I'll always be here with you, baby. I'm not going to leave.
Yeah. Richard Stark?
Yes?
I want you to know we're all behind you. Enjoy your trip back to London, England. We shall miss you.
Thank you, David. I shall miss all of you who are watching the round table with us. So thank you very much for inviting me in your homes for due to weather for Monday mornings, and may God bless you.
Beautiful. David Roxborough? What? You're not crying, aren't you? I have to cry because this is our final program. Excuse me. Sorry. I'm very sorry for you. Now, thank you very much for watching our program. We wish you, everybody, a very Merry Christmas and...
David, wait a minute!
What?
We can't close the show yet.
What do you mean?
We have to do your little thing.
Oh, you mean my singery?
Yeah, your singery.
Okay. Take it away. This is my swan song. My final swan song to everybody. This is for you, my dear, dear fans out there. My dear fans. Chestnuts roasting on an open fire, Jack Frost nipping at your nose, Yuletide carols being sung by a choir, and folks dressed up like Eskimos. Everybody knows a turkey and some mistletoe help to make the season bright. Tiny tots with their eyes all aglow will find it hard to sleep tonight. They know that Santa's
on his way. He's loaded lots of toys and goodies on his sleigh. And every mother's child is gonna spy to see if reindeer really know how to fly. And so I'm offering this simple phrase to kids from 1 to 92. Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas to you. And so I'm offering this simple phrase to kids from 1 to 92. Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas to you.
Well, I want to say thank you very much for letting me be in your homes for the final time. We wish everybody a Merry Christmas and a Happy, Happy New Year. We thank you very much for watching the Roundtable with us. Please, don't go anywhere. Email us right away at wdjbphilly04@gmail.com. If you like to, send us a friend request on Facebook and follow us on Twitter at DJWash5Philly. For Tom Barracroft, Chuck Strongbacks, David Roxborough, Chuck Davidson, and founder and president David Washington, I'm Charlie Martin, wishing you everybody a very Merry Christmas and a prosperous 2013 New Year. Good night and good morning.
This is Chuck Strongbacks. The Roundtable is a DJ Wash 5 and DWP production.
This is KDJW AM 1040 and KDJW TV Philadelphia. They are owned and operated by DJ Wash 5 and DWP Productions. Our programs may not be ordinarily used for any purpose except for exhibition of time of broadcasting. On receivers fit for home reception on your computers, iPods, iPads, or any mobile devices where there are no cover or operating charges are made. We thank you very much for watching our programs on Channel 5 and AM 1040 Philadelphia. God bless you. And Merry Christmas.
KDJW-TV Philadelphia and AM 1040 KDJW Philadelphia, owned and operated by DJ Wash 5.